My name is Craig Martin, and I'm the Chief Architect and COO of a multinational organization called Enterprise Architects. Now, this subject isn't about the architecture of buildings. We've borrowed that term to specifically talk about how we architect a business. Imagine you're a small business owner or part of an executive team within an organization. You're currently faced with a number of challenges, and those challenges vary from you're currently losing market share, you've got a product mix that's losing revenue, you've got some operational processes that are extremely inefficient across your organization. Not only that, you've kicked off a number of projects across your organization to be able to deal with some of these challenges. And you're not really sure whether those are the right projects and if you're investing in the right places to take advantages of some of these challenges. So what I want to introduce you to within this subject is a framework called TOGAF, which stands for the Open Group Architecture Framework. And this is really a standard on how to help you define the current state of your organization, all of your challenges and projects and activities that are occurring, begin to design the future state of your business, what it could look like, and then help you design a migration plan to be able to achieve that future state. I'm gonna take you through four modules and really look at the just an introduction into the discipline and introduce you to some of the basic concepts that TOGAF gives you to give you an understanding of how pieces of your organization fit together. I'm then going to look at a technique and how we actually design the business, how we assemble all of the structures of the organization so we can take advantage of some of the challenges that are sitting within the marketplace. So that's a technique on how to do architecture. We're then going to look at how we're actually going to migrate the business, in other words, how we're going to take some of these designs and these concepts and get the business to change and put plans in place and govern those changes so that the organization does actually change and it's not just plans on paper. And in our final module, we're going to look at the capability of architecture. In other words, how do you as an individual become an architect? What's your career path? What skills do you need to focus on? But then also how you fit into an organizational team. So enroll now and become part of the Enterprise Architecture community.